Mayors, councillors, members of parliament, very prominent, and she won her elections with a margin of 34,000 votes. You can imagine how popular she must be. Well, she is a really articulate foreign minister, so I wouldn't like to take much of your time. She has come here on this first official visit, and so far it has been very successful. Inshallah, it will be successful as well, 2 days that we have. She has explained various aspects of Pakistan foreign policy to the foreign secretary and other ministers and officials as the best representative of Pakistan. But on this occasion, she desired that we should talk of presenting a soft image of Pakistan. So when you walked up, you must have seen some handicrafts. It is all her efforts that they have come here on this for this occasion. And this exhibition will be on for a week. They're cottage industry made artifacts, and they need to be sponsored, patronized, and supported.
Thank you, High Commissioner, and thank you to all of you who have come here, who have made the time to come here. Let me just say that because I do see a lot of what can be called the Pakistani diaspora or the UK citizens with Pakistani origin over here, and that you are the real strength you are the link, you are the bridge that connects UK and Pakistan. And it is one hell of a bridge, because if you look at our relationship with the UK and the United Kingdom, over years, the strong historical cultural bonds that we've had have only come to become stronger still. And in any of the many, many avenues of our interaction, which is currently represented by the enhanced strategic dialogue that Prime Minister David Cameron started in Islamabad in April 2011 when he came to Islamabad, together with Prime Minister Gilani, in any of those strands of the dialogue, which include economic and development, which include trade and investment, which include security, which include cultural cooperation, in any of those, I think in the last few years, we have only come a long way. We have covered a lot of distance. And whether it is strategic cooperation vis-a-vis regional issues pertaining to the region that Pakistan is part of, pertaining to UK's own troops presence in Afghanistan, I think we have seen that while we may not be able to see eye to eye with many of our other partners, we have always found the UK to be able to understand Pakistan's particular or peculiar situation, peculiar predicament, and to stand beside us and behind us as a partner. And that is something which has strengthened this bond, which has given this relationship credibility, which has added an element of predictability to this relationship. And consider the fact that while the UK is going around the world on an austerity drive, ending some programs, is increasing its total outlay in supporting education in Pakistan. And guess why? Because the 20th Amendment or the 18th Amendment to the Constitution, which was made by Parliament recently, decided that education is now a universal right of every child in Pakistan. So what does the UK do? It supports a decision that is made by the Parliament of Pakistan. And this is what strengthens the bond, that you don't enforce your solutions, you support the solutions which are found by the people of Pakistan. So this is really a unique relationship with a Western partner, our relationship with the UK. And I am clearly not exaggerating when I say that the bond is because of the bridge that connects UK to Pakistan, and it is really many of you who are in the room today. Now, the last strand of this cooperation or the strategic dialogue is one which is very close to my heart and very close to the heart of this government. That is that of cultural cooperation. Pakistan is maligned endlessly the world over for what are its perceived intentions, what are its perceived interests. I think as Pakistanis we do an awful job of articulating what our real interests are, what are real goals and objectives to find regional peace and stability within the region that we inhabit. And Pakistan, no matter what is said, please remember one thing. Pakistan is a country which has lost the stability that it had 10 years from today by being a frontline state for the world's international effort to bring stability to Afghanistan. So we are the sufferers, and we are the ones who have caused our people to suffer, to lose lives, 30,000 in numbers. We have sacrificed our soldiers, our paramilitary, our police. We have sacrificed our economic well-being to be an effective world partner. And what do we expect in return? A modicum of respect, respect for our sovereignty, respect for the inviolability of our borders, respect for our territorial integrity. And barring that, and without that, nobody can expect Pakistan to be an effective partner. And that is the will of the people of Pakistan, which has to be appreciated, which has to be respected, and which has to be adhered to. So what I was talking about was the last strand in this cooperation, which is that of cultural. So while the narrative against Pakistan is always hard, is always hostile, there is a softer, better, very likable part of Pakistan that exists everywhere. It exists in our Sufis, in the poetry that Pakistan has, in the art that Pakistan has, in the people that Pakistanis are, and it exists in the rural crafts of Pakistan. That is an effort that the government made in the form of Ahan, Ek Hunar, Ek Nagar. If you interpret it, it means one village, one product. This project was started in many other countries and was very successfully carried out in many other countries. But I think in Pakistan, we have been able to achieve a rare success. That we have taken the craft of the people within the rural areas on their doorstep. We have given them expertise to be able to make it more marketable. And downstairs, within the High Commission, we have a room which is dedicated to this craft. I would encourage each one of you to take a look at this product line. It is all fair trade. It is going and giving people a means of income right at their home so they don't have to migrate into urban centers and burden the urban centers of Pakistan any further. So I would, in whatever way you can, please support these product lines, because whatever effort you will make, not only in buying it, but introducing it to buyers, introducing it to more of your friends, telling us ways and means of being able to market it better in this country, in the far corners of this country, because whatever effort you will make, it will go to a deservedly poor rural home in Pakistan. So it's a great cause to support, and we hope that in being able to support causes like this, each one of us gives back to the society and to the country and to the culture and to the place which has given us so much in return. So with that, let me just thank the presence, thank you all for your presence today, and say that it is an honor for me to be representing Pakistan. And I am very sure, I don't know if how many other people are, that Pakistan has a future which is very, very bright. And Pakistan is a country which will prove that the resilience of its people and the strength of its people will take it to places that we have never seen before. So with that, I thank you all for your attention.
And while you go back or you come up, see the artifacts that you have laid up downstairs. They will be on display for the next 5-7 days on this hall from day after. And you can purchase them, you can support them, whatever you want to do, you can do that. Thank you very much.